We started talking this morning with Mr. Christopher Ryan, and we got into our privacy. There's a great article that I'll have this weekend in my newsletter from the Daily Mail about this whole thing. And it's titled, Read This and You Won't Click I Agree Ever Again. So we got into that and also into this new bill here. It's called the Ending Platform Monopolies Act. Can we split up these huge companies, these social media companies, etc., that are providing various platforms? Should we split them up? This is a real interesting topic and one that's going to affect every last one of us. And of course, Chris and I both had opinions on it.
I am Chris Ryan. Craig Peterson is the host of Tech Talk on News Radio 610 and 96.7, Saturdays and Sundays at 11:30 a.m. One of the more fascinating things about the tech environment is how either we don't care or it's unbeknownst to us that we allow for tech companies to spy on us and to have an inner track basically to our minds and to our souls, where for many years we always wondered what other people were thinking, right? Like, what is that person thinking? And there was no way to ever really know. But now there are ways to know, because we look into things on Google, we look into things via searches, and we like certain things, we agree on certain things, and as a result of that, we at some points in time are just giving the money, giving information to tech companies, but other points in time, we're actually showing via social media who we are in ways that we never would have done in the past. And employers, friends, everybody get a completely different view of a person's true inner feelings and how their mind works via social media that we never had before.
It is potentially a huge problem. We've got these busybodies, if you will, that are listening to basically all of the signals we're sending out. We tell them where we live. You may not have given them your address, but if you have apps on your phone, that you're guaranteed that smartphone now stays in the same house every night. They know where you live. They know what you like because of what you're searching for online, the websites you're going to. They know what you say with some of these devices. My son was over his girlfriend's house and had a conversation with her about getting a hammock in front of one of these little portals from our friends at Facebook. Immediately, ads started showing up for all of this. So we're telling these tech companies everything that we're doing. We have microphones in our rooms. Our televisions, Vizio, which is one of the major manufacturers, was caught watching us, knowing who is looking at the TV, when they're looking at it, so they can get better ratings. Microphones are being used. The spy agencies worldwide now have direct access to us. It's a real problem, and it's a problem for you and me, not just for someone that's a high value target. It's a problem for you and me because now all of this information is also available to the regular bad guys. That's what they're using for phishing. They're getting you to do things. Now, marketers are getting you to do things, obviously, by getting all this information, showing you the right information at the right time. The bad guys are getting you to do things by clicking on links, going to websites that are actually going to cause you harm. And we're seeing huge increases in all of this, Chris.
Right. And it's those types of things which happen behind the scenes, but it's also a lot of the outward things. What do you post about? What do you say? How do you interact with other people? All these types of things are accessible to the public at times and also accessible behind the scenes as well. And it allows for a catalog to be built on you as an individual. And we are giving insight into our inner thinkings and our process that we would never have thought about, that our parents would have never thought about doing before. And as a result of that, there is a lot of things that take place out in society that we may not understand or we may not completely comprehend, but a lot of it has to do with our behavior on social media and our inability to know when to say things and when not to say things. And that is a huge problem.
It is, Nord, what a shut up. It's right there in politics as well. The Obama campaign was the first to mine incredible amounts of data from Facebook. Incredible. They had far more access than anyone had ever had before. Facebook just literally gave it to them. Mm-hmm. And then you had the Trump campaign come along and hire the Cambridge Analytica guys who had access to much less data than the Obama campaign had. But in both cases, you were seeing ads that were so tightly targeted at people, at individuals, that you really were being manipulated, because they know what you're saying, they know what you're doing, they know who your friends are, and they put it all together now to lead you down that primrose path, whatever it might be. That's where I really get concerned. We are absolutely being manipulated, and as you pointed out, Chris, we're being manipulated voluntarily. We're telling them everything we possibly can about us when we're posting on these various sites.
That's a really good point. House Judiciary Committee approved antitrust legislation that could prohibit platform operators like Amazon, Apple, Google, and Facebook from favoring their own products and services. And the legislation could even break up industry giants by forcing them to eliminate or sell certain divisions. I don't see any way, shape, or form that this becomes law. That being said, there is a public desire for law to come to fruition that creates a more even playing field, breaks up big tech, breaks up these corporate giants, and creates an environment where there is more shared prosperity. And I'm curious as to what your thoughts are on this and what direction this goes in. Do these companies need to be broken up in your view, A, and B, given how tightly they're able to control political figures via donations and power and things of that nature, is there any way that these big tech companies get broke?
It's a great question, and I would love to say that let the marketplace take care of it. But these companies are so incredibly profitable, the odds of them going under are very slim. Look at how long now we've had Facebook and Google out there. I'm sure their predecessors died. Their predecessors kind of went away. MySpace, et cetera. But these people have had so much control, so much money, so much profit, that the odds that they are going to be corrected by the marketplace are slim. Because part of the problem, Chris, with these huge guys is they keep everybody else out of the market. Look at Instagram, a company that was worth maybe $50 million. Facebook has been out there paying $1 billion to buy their prospective competition, and they've done it multiple times. Google's done it multiple times. We're talking about 100 times what the company is worth just so they don't have to face competition. So now that brings in this Ending Platform Monopolies Act that you just mentioned. Will that help? Yeah, but I don't know. How do you break them up? There's obvious ways you could slice them up, but is there the stomach for the federal government to get involved in this? And we're just giving it all to these companies with margins, profit margins, that are insane.
As always, Craig, thank you so much. Appreciate your time. We'll talk again soon.
Hey, take care.
Craig Peterson joining us here on Hampshire Day, host of Tech Talk on News Radio 610 and 96.7, Saturdays and Sundays at 11:30 a.m.